Welcome to the new campus for Aspen Country Day School and the Aspen Music Festival and School. We start our tour by turning off Castle Creek Road and on to Music School Road. The first building you see on the left is our new lower school building, which is part of the very first phase of construction to be complete upon our return from our school year abroad at the Aspen Meadows. The lower school building brings us 12 brand new classrooms, cubby rooms, offices, an art and science studio, and a large gathering area with a fireplace. It looks out onto the river with fenced play areas appropriate for the younger children and an imaginative wildlands play area as well. All the classrooms in this building are connected by a learning street, a main hallway with a clear ceiling that brings in natural light all along the length of the building. Parking and circulation will be much improved from our current situation. A loop road goes all the way around, and that keeps the center of the campus clear, a more pedestrian-friendly layout such as you would find on a college campus. Now we're going across the existing middle bridge into the center of the campus. Here you can see how this area, where cars now come and go all day, becomes a central gathering place. Cars can still drive through on occasion, but this section now becomes free for children to circulate safely throughout the day. This is a new building that will be added to the south of the existing Castle Creek Classroom building. This is where we anticipate having our older students, and they can go outside to play on the central quad. This facility, along with the renovation of the Castle Creek building, is part of the final phase of construction, phase three. Now we're turning right across the central pedestrian commons. This begins the pond cluster of three buildings to be finished in phase one. There is one for each of the arts in our arts program. First drama, then music in the middle, then art on the south side. One thing we like about this design is that it really puts the arts at the center of our campus. Here is the large building that will be first our gym in phase one. It then becomes our theater once the gym is finished in phase two. It looks out across the pond at the newly reconstructed campus. This is the new building on what used to be our gym. It has plenty of room for all the games we play. It has beautiful windows that look out over the pond with shades to keep out the glare. There's a balcony overhead, and when it is in use as our drama center, this should be a superb performance space for our Shakespeare plays, all school assemblies, and presentations of projects. We come back outside and turn left along the walkway that goes along the edge of the pond. One feature of the buildings that were here before that we've kept to preserve the feel of the old campus is a beautiful glass-walled room cantilevered over the pond. This will be our music classroom, and it also has something new to Country Day in this building, plenty of bathrooms centrally located. Outside is the commons where we expect to see many classes gathering for outdoor learning on nice days. For the music school, this is a place to rehearse and read sheet music. For us, it will be one of those social spots where children can come and see each other and greet their friends as they move throughout their day. Back out onto the walkway where the old gym used to be, turning, we look straight ahead to the third building in this pond cluster. This is a spacious art studio, complete with facilities for all the visual arts we do at school. This will be a sunny, great place for art making and instruction for all ages. We go through another passageway along the ponds with views out across the water. The old administration building is on the right, with the music festival's new offices upstairs, and on the left, a new dining hall. The festival's practice rooms ring the campus. From the new dining hall, which will be an amazing improvement over our current cozy cafeteria, we can have our lunches in a peaceful setting. We can open the doors and go out towards the ponds and enjoy the sun at noon. Now, turning right and going down the path to what is now the lower school. The tiny pond on the right where we have the regatta has been filled in, and we are heading towards the new gymnasium, the gym we have always wanted. It has a very high ceiling, as this will be used in the summer as the music festival's large rehearsal hall. It has storage as well, which will be great during transition times in May and September. The gym gives on to a big playing field where we can play field games all through the school year. That's something new, plenty of room to play. Now we're going over the new upstream bridge past the maintenance buildings and toward another group of practice rooms and what the music festival calls the percussion building. This is to be completed in phase one as well. There is room here for perhaps our foreign language program or for the older children, class Socratic seminars with everyone participating from around a central table. Now we turn back toward the center of the campus, crossing over the small footbridge that is there now. We're looking back into the campus from the upstream point. Here you can see how the buildings are arranged. You can see deep into the campus and all its new possibilities. Here our tour ends. Thank you for joining us.